A very good evening, dear all. I welcome you to the session on speech writing. I'm sorry in the evening because of the internet connectivity, I couldn't take the class, but now I am hopeful the things will be better. So without wasting time, let's get started. Speech writing. So dear children, what you are going to learn today? You will learn to understand the processes involved in writing long composition, which is speech, value points and presentation style of speech, the marking scheme as per CBSE, and you will also learn to write different speeches by attempting the questions given at the end of this presentation. So yes, again I am discussing with you the CBSE syllabus 2020-21, class 11th and class 12th. So here it is very clearly mentioned that article, speech and report. And for class 11th it is 8 marks and for class 12th it is 10 marks. Okay, so here it is mentioned for class 12th, article, debate and speech and report. Fine. There is one more long composition for class 11, narrative writing. So dear children, the distribution of marks for class 11th is 1 mark. And here it is written title and writer's name. So dear children, format doesn't include only these two. There are many other things also which we must take care of. Yes, but you remember just for shortcut, title and writer's name. Content is 3 marks. Expression is 4 marks. And in expression, there are two further division. Grammatical accuracy, appropriate words and spellings, 2 marks. And coherence and relevance of ideas and style, 2 marks. Word limit is 150-200 words, marks 8, so 144 in this word, and these are subdivision. And time available is 20 minutes. Right. So I will discuss time later on, which after class 12th. So distribution of marks for class 12th is, format is 1 mark, content is 4 marks, expression is 5 marks. Grammatical accuracy, appropriate words and spelling is 2.5 mark. Coherence and relevance of ideas and style is 2.5 mark. So altogether 5 marks. So these are the subdivision of expression. So you can see the criteria is the same, only the marks allocation is different. So yes, same word limit is also the same. For 11th and 12th, 150-200 words, only the difference is marks. So for 11th it is 8 marks, for 12th it is 10 marks. And yes, time limit 20 minutes. Dear children, again and again I tell you, just take care of this time. Because I suggest you that when you attempt first 1 or 2 or 3 questions of speech, just to make yourself aware of how to write a speech, then you need not to see the time. But after that, whenever you work, whenever you write any of the writing item, just take care of this time limit. Otherwise it will be very difficult for you to complete the question paper in exam. You don't have only speech writing or only article writing or only any other question, there are many. So if you are sticking or you are practicing according to time, then it's going to be of a great help to you. Then you can manage your time during exam very easily. So after marking scheme, now let us come to speech. Dear children, the purpose of making a speech is to convey information orally to a large gathering of people strongly and convincingly. So this is important, that you have to connect with your audience. You will say, ma'am, we are writing, we are not speaking. Yes, dear children, but it is expected that whatever you are writing, you should be able to connect with the audience, and you should be strong enough in your arguments and also convince. It must have the ability to convince others. Now let us come to the important points that we must take care of while writing speech. So the first is, begin it with a quotation if you can, and make sure it should not be mandatory that you are starting your speech with a quotation. So your quotation must be relevant to the topic, then only use a quotation. Yes, and the beginning, this is the part of your format. Greet the audience and the dignitaries. How? So you, when your speech format is this one. When we were discussing format, the title, and so here your title, that was a mistake. Oh, so I'm sorry. So here I couldn't delete it. Class 11th, may be careful, okay? So in the format of the speech, you have to be very clear about this line. This first line which you write is actually the part of your format. So in a speech, the format is these lines, and then at the end, thank you, not thanking you. Thanking you is written in letters. In speech, thank you. Okay, so you are going to begin with your speech with respected principal, esteemed teachers, and dear fellow students. Or you may write, good morning to highly honorable chief guest and highly respected guest of honor, and to all the other ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Sometime if you even write good morning and you start your speech, then also you will get marks for a speech. But it is good if you address and you greet the audience and dignitaries, because they are going to listen to your speech. Okay, so after this you may write, today I stand before you to say a few words on, about, whatever. A very good morning to one and all present here. I told you, you may start like this also, or you just write good morning and then start, respected principal, teachers, and my dear friends, whatever. Today I stand before you to express my views, or like here, today I will throw light on, it is my proud privilege to give a speech on, whatever. Then yes, if possible, you may include an anecdote. What is an anecdote? Story. But again, like quotation, only if it is relevant to the topic on which you are writing speech. So be sure about it. Yes, try to include humor, fun, laughter in the speech. This is important. But if you do it, then obviously you can connect to your audience very nicely. But if you can't, let it be. But this point is very, very important. Talk or that's why I have written it in, typed it in a different color. So this is very important. Talk or deliver the speech in such a way that the audience gets involved. So connecting with your audience is very, very important in speech writing. Ask questions to the audience. So if you ask questions to the audience, obviously they will be connected. So this style you must learn. And yes, be sweet by being brief. Don't use jargons, unnecessary long sentences, confusing references. No, be simple, brief, and clear. So some of the value points I wish to discuss with you, but later on, by the end of the class, I believe that the speech writing will be very crystal clear in your head. Organize your ideas on the speech, on the subject concerned. Add sub points to the main points. Draft or create from your own experience. Substantiate your argument if you are writing on a debatable topic, but here it is, speech, it is not required. Transcode and incorporate diagrammatic information in your composition. Sometimes you may use some reference to some data. Okay, so you may use that. Here it doesn't mean diagrammatic, doesn't mean that you draw a diagram, never. An argumentative composition generally contains introduction of the issues, causes, facts, and data. I was talking about outcome, results, suggestion, measures to improve the situation. It depends on the topic of your speech. If your speech is on some debatable, or you can say some, it's not necessary, it is always a debate, but if it the topic is controversial, or you have to give your opinion, so in that way you may use, because when you write a speech you give both the points, so in that case this will be a great help to you. Anyways, forward. Yes, statements to help writing a speech. Earlier also I have discussed this here with you, because this is a wonderful piece example for you. How to open, how to introduce point, how to present ideas and give example, how to express result and reason, how to contrast opinion, concluding everything. So here are very good shared items, shared language items, which you can use in any of your long composition, like your article, your speech and your debate. Okay. But in article you have to be very clear, because you have to be very objective. You have not to use first and second person. But in a speech and debate you have to use first and second person, because you have to connect with your audience. So be clear about it. Yes, so just again a quick reading. Opening, it is often said that many people claim that in this the day and age, nowadays, these days, we live in an age where many of us are, is hotly debated topic that often divides opinion. For debate it's good, is often discussed yet rarely understood. It goes without saying that is one of the most important issues facing us today. The following essay takes a look at both sides of the argument. Introducing points, like you can this is a beautiful thing you can do, and very easy for you to give a shape to your speech, article or debate. So you may write, firstly let us take a look at to start with, first of all it is worth considering, secondly, thirdly, fourthly, furthermore, in addition, what is more, on top of that, another point worth noting is, another factor to consider is, lastly, finally, last but not the least. So this is wonderful to give a proper shape to your any lengthy composition. Then for presenting ideas, you can give examples, like when it comes to and after that you have to use noun or gerund. In terms of, again you have to use after this any noun or gerund, then with respect to noun or gerund, not only but also according to experts, research has found that there are those who argue that, for instance, for example, such as. So beautiful language items to present your ideas and give examples. Expressing result and reason, so you can, this way you can say, as a result of, has led to, has resulted in, consequently, therefore, on account of, due to, one reason behind this is, and contrasting, although, even though, subject plus verb, despite, in spite of, noun or gerund, despite the fact that, subject plus verb, on the one hand, on the other hand, however, nevertheless, even so. And for concluding, you may use, to sum up, in conclusion, all things considered, taking everything into consideration, weighing up both sides of the argument, the advantages of outweighs the disadvantages, and opinion, as far as I'm concerned, from my point of view, in my opinion, personally speaking, my own view in this matter. So you may use this for debate and speeches. So dear children, you have one one thing in your hand, and that is, don't wonder that how you will be able to write all these statements. So You can do one thing. You can pause my video and just write down all these in your fair notebook, because this is going to be a great help to you while writing any lengthy composition. These are wonderful pieces of language share. Shared language, okay? So let's proceed. So some more explanation and example. I found a wonderful resource online. I wish to share it with you. Yes. So step by step writing a speech. So there are 7 steps. Yes. So before you start writing, you must think about it. What? Who you are writing your speech for? Okay. Why are you writing? What your speech is going to be about? How long it needs to be? But you may remember the word limit. No need to go for the minutes. Okay. So these WH questions, if you know, it will be very easy for you to write your speech. One thing more I found it good here, which I want to share. Yes, wonderful. So here, yes. So you can see that key ingredients of a superb speech sandwich. So it explained how the speech is. So sandwich, the upper layer is opening. The middle big with the burger the sticky and the mayonnaise and the vegetables are all the bodies, and then the end is the base. You understanding the base of the sandwich? Like that is your conclusion. It is not only for speech, it is for your article also, and it is for your debate also. So remember, it is like sandwich. The first layer opening, the middle stuffing is body, and the last is the conclusion. Now let's come beyond. So what else I found good here is, so remember WH questions, then writing or oral language. Yes, this is very important. So you have to use oral language, like means in article, because article is read. You are supposed to write written language. Are you getting? In which you have to be very objective. No use of first or second person. You have to use passive voice. You have to be very indirect. But for your speech and debate, you have to use the oral language. So what is the oral language? Where you use I, you, ask questions, and your language should be like conversing with the audience. Fine. Next thing I think which is important to which is mentioned here. Yes. By practice you will know this, but very important, you have to check the note of your language. It shouldn't be rude, okay? And yes, very important, you should check the length of your sentences. Your language should not be, the sentences should not be lengthy, okay? I will show you more about it. So your language, the length of your sentences should not be lengthy. And yes, your language which you are using, it should be very clear. Okay. And that's all. I think there were 7 points, but I find these were very, very important. The ending. So ending should be highly memorable. It should have an impact, like that sandwich which you have seen. Burger you have seen. The base is like supporting all the layers on the top. I'm liking this very much. This burger. Not for eating, but for explanation. Wonderful explanation. Here it is. Yes. So you see, this base is like to support, giving support to all the above layers. So your conclusion should be covering all the above layers, only the middle stuffing, not only the middle stuffing, which is your body of your letter, sorry, application, speech, but also the introduction, the opening of your speech. Fine? Okay, so let's come back to the PPT and I'm going to show you something. It's a wonderful video which I found online, and it's a good one. So speech structure. So how you are going to structure your speech, this is very important. So the first good morning, you see here, this is welcome. Then you can also write that introductory sentences which I have told you, shown you. Then outline topic, yes, very important. In the very first paragraph for your speech, you must outline that topic. I will show you how you can outline that topic. Then the first main point, and see, you see the system. Secondly, first of all, finally, then your second first main point is here, second main point is here, third main point is here, and the last, you're summing up your argument in summary and saying thank you for listening. See how your speech should be after writing. It should be in this look. Okay? Oh, sorry. I'm sorry I missed it. Anyway, it's very difficult with the tech, these technical things. Okay, so I explain you. Yeah, so these techniques are for any of the writing question in the exam. So be clear, which I am discussing with you is not only for your speech, but for your article, your report, and for your debate also, all the four writing skills. Though I will take again the same thing with you in the debate writing session, but you must take care of it. See, dear children, writing such a section is not difficult. The only thing is that if you are thorough with how to write your points, how to begin, how to end, what is the format of your that particular writing item, you will get good marks. Fine. Yes, so the goal is, so goal of each text is the same, persuade the readers to agree with you. So with practice you will learn how you can do it. So tip one is 5 bullet point structure. So I have shown you what is 5 bullet point structure. So write this plan for both writing question in exam. So what's that? Oh, I don't know what, why next time I'm going to play video in so write this plan for we have done away that. Yes, here comes the structure. He's writing, or this one, the one who has made this video, has written all questions. So all questions means all your lengthy compositions, long composition. Yes, so paragraph one will be the introduction in 2 sentences, 2 or 3, not more than that. In paragraph two, first main point, and you may use an example to support your main point, or you may discuss your main point, or you can give some sub points to it, but not in the form of note making. It should be in the form of a paragraph. Don't write 1, 2, 3, 4. No, you have to write it in a paragraph. Then paragraph 3 should have your second main point, same discussion or supporting points. You may give reference to some data as well. paragraph 4, same as the first and the second paragraph second and third, and the last is your conclusion. Again, conclusion should be 2 or 3 sentences, not more than that. So 1 point per paragraph, this is to be noted down. No need to write many points paragraph wise. 1 point per paragraph is more than enough. Do not put lots of points in a big chunk. Very, very important for your article, speech, debate, and for a report as well. Otherwise, by the end you will get exhausted and you will not have ideas to write on. So it's good if you take one idea per paragraph. Yeah. So here is a letter to editor, but don't think that I am teaching it to letter to editor, but the point which I am discussing with you goes for letter to editor as well. So this is wrong. You're saying it's such a big chunk in a big paragraph. Just two lines and then such a big chunk, and then yours faithfully or Gabby whatever. So you, this is completely wrong. You can divide these points in different paragraphs. It will give a good look to your writing item, not only this lengthy item, but also in this case of letters as well. Yes, so see, this is a good example. Don't see the address here, it should come here. Mainly the focus on the paragraph. So see here, the first paragraph, 2 lines introduction, second paragraph is first main point, and the third paragraph is second main point, fourth paragraph is conclusion. If you do this much enough in your article, debate or speech or letter to editor, this is a good thing. See how well structured this is. So very clear, you can see this is looking very attractive and this is not looking that attractive. So you can see on your own. So again, I'm telling you, this is for all the lengthy writing composition, long writing composition, and also letter to editor. So try not to have huge sentences. If you have one that is 4 or 5 lines long, so you need to put a full stop in. Meaning to say, you have to stop. Don't put all the points in one paragraph. You have to be judicious enough to have different paragraphs for different points. Yes, second is first point was you should not write all the big points, all the points in one big paragraph. But second is also, not only the paragraph should be big, it should be divided into different paragraphs, but also your sentences should not be lengthy. Your sentences should be short, like see here. Okay. So 7 to 8 short, medium and longer sentences. So remember, your sentences should, instead of writing one sentence to 5 lines, into 5 lines, it is good to write 4 or 5 sentences. Getting? So if you do it, your writing item, any lengthy writing item, not only speech, I agree that I'm teaching you speech writing, but the same point goes for your debate, article, report and letter to editor as well. So be short in your sentence. Instead of making one huge sentence, one very big sentence, write 2-3 sentences instead. So yes, so you have to give a speech to your class. So the internet is, for example, it's giving an example to you. This is wonderful example for you to learn. So the title is The Internet, a Blessing or the Worst Thing to Heaven Ever. So see, the how are you going to organize this speech? Same structure. So see what we are going to do. So how this speech is structured. So paragraph one, the best thing, okay, it's a blessing. Then second is social media, third is Google Map, four is cyber bullying, bad thing. So positive and then negative and then goodbye. But you have to use thank you. This is some foreign country. This video is of some foreign country. So wherever the changes are there, I will tell you, discuss with you. So tip two is show off to the examiner. Means you should show off to the examiner that your English is great. You know very much good English. Even if it is not, you can do it. You can feign. So how I'm telling you? Oh, I hate this thing. You were somewhere here. I hope it's clear. So you have to be your address should be direct. You may use rhetorical questions, exciting adjectives and statistics. This is important. So how you are going to do it? Let's see the example. Fine. So here you see all the blues are adjectives. So here, disgust, dreadful, appalling, horrible, cramped, stupidity. So it's not clear, shocked. So in this way, exciting adjectives are used. Then direct address. So here you see the direct address, the yellow you. So it is like directly addressing your public. When you say, okay, you don't you think this, don't you believe, will you agree with me, and other sentences like this. So your address should be direct in a speech and also in debate. Okay, this is very much, this direct address is for both. For both means for debate and a speech. An exciting adjective is for all the long composition. But direct address must be only and only in your speech and debate. And yes, statistic. According to survey, according to the recent whatever data are related to the survey or what we say, research in the field, like that. And rhetorical question, yes, you may ask question, how can you justify, and how often are the room cleaned, why should I have to put up this. So you may ask questions like this just to engage your audience. Simple, easy, you can do it. Yes, that's very easy. Even if your English is not too good, so using these techniques, you can write a wonderful speech and debate and also all the long compositions. Let's proceed. Yes, so I have discussed with you. Three is write a great introduction. So how to write a great introduction, that's wonderfully explained here. Oh my god, what's wrong with it? Yes, so here is the example. I'm so sorry dear. Next time I'm not going to have the video play in. Yes. So what does this previous slide said? That the exam question will help you to write a good introduction. How? Let's see. Yes. So see here, the exam question is you have to give a speech to your class. The title is "The Internet, a Blessing or the Worst Thing to Happen Ever." So good morning, and your address, and then "I am here to deliver talk on title is here." See, as it is copied here, in this speech I am going to say, why couldn't we live without the internet? So directly from question, this line has been taken, and very common line. In this speech I am going to say, why I couldn't live without the internet. How emphatic the introduction is. Introduction done. So can't you write such introduction? Yes, you can. That's easy, not very difficult and not very technical. It's very easy, plain sailing. Fine. So imagine you have a friend or relative who is considering going to live abroad. So write a letter of opinion. I may stop it because letter is not in our syllabus. Fine. Yes. So who is considering? So letter of opinion, you need not write. Consider it like a speech. Yes. Use sentence starters. Yes, I told you already that this is very easy. Like in every paragraph, you may write firstly, first paragraph will be introduction, then second paragraph write firstly the first point with explanation, discussion. If you have data to discuss, you may write with examples. Then write the second, third paragraph should be secondly, start, begin with it. Then thirdly, finally, and last, to conclude, to sum up. So you can do this, fine. So this, dear children, you can do with all the long composition. Again and again I'm telling you, it's the same. See how beautiful it is. Good morning, first paragraph, firstly, secondly, finally, and in summary, or to conclude. Are you seeing how well managed, well planned this speech is? Yes. So again, we have come to the back, the first slide. So good morning, and then how we are going to organize, and last should be thank you. Again repeating, no thanking you. No, you are not supposed to write thanking you. You are supposed to write thank you. So speeches. So you have been asked to give a speech on thing that annoy me the most. Things that annoy me the most. And try to be entertaining and persuade to your class. Generally, you don't get this type of question, but still, the things which have been explained here, it will be very helpful to you. Like say hi and what you are going to talk about. So instead of hi, you are going to write good morning. With the respected principal, teachers, and my dear friends, today I just stand before you to express my views on, or today I, whatever the language item I have discussed with you, or anything else also which you think is good. And yes, you should use you, we, I, first, second person, very compulsory for debate in a speech. try to persuade the reader to agree with you. And yes, firstly, secondly, however, nevertheless, like this. Then the forest, you feel it, leave it, and then check your there, and they are very, very important, because generally the student they mix with there and their spelling. So this is possessive, and there is a demonstrative pronoun there, pointing towards a place, and they are is the short form of they are. Use a rhetorical question to involve the audience. So this is all about your speech. Fine. Now we can move to second. My God, this slide was very much impatient to come on the screen. So finally it is here. So dear, I am going to read a solid example of a speech, and you just see that, first of all, see the structure. You see, introduction, first paragraph, second paragraph, conclusion. So write a speech in 150 to 200 words on the topic, discipline shapes the future of a student. It is to be delivered in the morning assembly. You are Karuna or Karan. So respected principal, teachers and dear friends, today I, Karuna, comma, I am here to express my views on comma, and then inverted comma start the title. Discipline shapes the future of a student. We are all aware of the fact that discipline is a key to success. Introduction over. Two lines, introduction over. Then first point. This end first second paragraph. Discipline should be inculcated early in life. If we are disciplined in life, we inculcate a sense of duty and obedience. Let me give you an example to prove my point. Every day we are assigned homework by our teachers. If we are disciplined, we complete the work within the stipulated time. We get the appreciation of the teachers and also do well in the examination. This is a lengthy sentence. You can split this long sentence in two. Okay, that will be more. Actually, it is an example which has been picked up, so it is not a perfect example. So you must see what we can do. So everything is okay with this paragraph. Point is also good. The only thing is that this sentence is very lengthy, so we can split it in two or three, right, sentences. Now next, discipline is essential in all walks of life. It is third paragraph dealing with second point. Right from the working of the government of the country to the ordinary farmer who tills his field, all follow discipline. It is the bedrock of character. Absence of it leads to chaos and confusion. Imagine a day on the road when people do not follow the traffic rules. You can imagine the utter chaos it will lead to. So discipline is essential running the society smoothly. So done. And last, a person can reach the pinnacles of glory by following discipline. It acts as a restraint and at the same time builds self-confidence. Moreover, comma should be here. It balances the personality of a person and inculcates good work ethics. Dear children, I purposefully have selected this sample because this is not 100% perfect sample. So this is your homework as well. Just try to make this speech a better piece. See, format wise wonderful, and thank you must be here at the end. Let me write it. I can do it now. So you can write at the end, thank you. Fine. So this is a format wise this is a good structure. Properly you can see first, second, third, fourth, fifth paragraph. First, fine, this is the address, the beginning, the format is this and this. And good morning also, Shushpray. Good morning and respect Divan. This is the format. And yes, this how you see the clear division of the paragraphs. Understand? And yes, in exam you are going to left align your debate, speech, article, everything. I have already told you. And if to show that you have changed a paragraph, you must leave a line. This is the latest format. Okay. And yes, one thing more, if you are reading some samples of speech in any book or anywhere or online, I suggest you one thing. It's not only for speech, it is for all compositions. Focus on how you can make that piece a better one. Then you will learn. If you simply cram the lines from the already written work, no learning will not happen. Yes, you must note down some of the good expressions, some of the good the quotations or some proverbs. It's good to note down, but focus on how you can make that piece a better one. So as I have shown you a sample here, so some changes were needed here and some here also. Here moreover, comma is not there. So you must focus on what are the mistakes in that piece and how you can correct that. Fine. So dear children, now here are 5 questions for you to practice. Tomorrow dear children, I am going to discuss with you that all your doubts. There will be a different separate session on doubts of which you have asked me. So I'm going to deal with all the doubts, and I was reminded of one of the doubt and one of the problem. One of the students said that please give us homework. Dear children, every class is giving you a homework, and here's the homework. In all the session I have taken, I have given you a little homework for practice. I have given shared with you the links online. Anyways, so here you see again the practice questions. With all writing items, I have given practice questions. So you pause the videos, because now these videos will be available online on YouTube. So you can pause and note down all the important points or whatever you think is useful to you. So we are done with speech writing, luckily, without any glitch or now and without this internet sleeping. And yes, without it's very important to mention that the pictures which I have used here, they are all downloaded from internet. I have not made any of the picture. And yes, PowerPoint is, this is created for learning and not for the commercial purpose. So see you tomorrow, and tomorrow I am going to take 2 sessions. So one is going to be the debate writing, and with that I believe that your writing section will be complete, except narrative writing. So that's not that difficult, you may do if you have this much knowledge. And and if I get time in future, I surely will share with you. And second, I will be taking with you the doubt clearance session. So till then, bye.